In an effort to try to make Sunday morning's quickies quick again, I had really only prepared two items that I wanted to cover this week. I wanted to go back and revisit the modification of older 66s to add timing marks and a timing gauge for the needle clamp. And I wanted to talk about, to follow up on last week's video on rock shafts, to talk about the differences between some of the pivot points that you'll find. Like, for example, on this 99, where you have the vertical shaft with its pivot points as well as the rock shafts. Now, that would also cover machines like the 66, the 192, the 27, 28, 127, 128, yada, yada, yada. Anything where you have a vertical shaft that's oscillating back and forth. Anyway, I wanted to talk about the differences in the pivot points. That's all we're going to talk about this week. The other solution that I wanted to discuss vis-a-vis the modifying the machines for the timing marks and the timing gauge, I wanted to show you how you can make your own timing gauge to put into the machine and how to mark. I've showed how to mark in the past the needle clamp. I've got another way of doing it, which works equally well. And I will show you all that in the future. Unfortunately, the materials that I had chosen initially to make the gauges, there's really no good safe way of doing that at home. So I've dropped back 20 and I'm going to punt. I ordered some material from K&S Precision Metals out in Chicago. It should be here in a few days, but it's just not going to be here in time to put into this video. So this week we're going to keep it reasonably short and we're just going to talk about these pivot points and how you can avoid a problem. Now, I've got a customer, not mentioning any names, who contacted me. She had been following along with the videos, and she was cleaning the underside of her 99. Anyway, this particular pivot point for the vertical shaft, her machine, it was rather filthy. She wanted to clean it. Now, she did not know, she did not realize that these two pivot points, although the screws may look the same, they are not equal. She removed this, which I will do right now. Got that nut loose. I'm just going to take the nut completely off. I'll set it to the side. And she took the screw out. She cleaned everything up, cleaned the nut up. She's cleaning stuff. She also had the rock shafts out. She had the hardware for that off. She cleans it, puts it aside, yada, yada, yada. She goes to reassemble her machine. She takes this pivot point, one from here, she starts screwing it in to the bottom. It gets so far and it stops. She turns it a little bit more. Uh-oh. It's jammed. It's a problem. So, what had happened was this. This pivot point for the rock shaft, it's 3/8 of an inch. It is 28 threads per inch. This pivot screw for the bottom of the vertical shaft is also 3/8 of an inch, but it's 24 threads per inch. So when she screwed that 28 thread per inch screw in this 24, she stripped out part of the threads. All right. She didn't go in all that far. It is repairable. This is a set of taps that I had bought at McMaster-Carr. Now, I don't need all three of these for this. There's a standard tap, there's a plug tap, and there's a bottoming tap. Using the standard tap, getting the vertical shaft down and out of the way, off to the side, down and out of the way. Once the machine arrives, I'll be able to start the tap in that hole and then just run it all the way through, so it's down and out of the way, and chase the threads. It's literally called chasing the threads, and go through and clean out those threads and reform the threads back in the casting. Once it joins up with the non-damaged threads, everything's going to be fine. I know I can fix her problem. She didn't go that far in. But read this as a warning. These are different threads at these two points. Now, I also own a 3/8 by 28 tap, which, as you'll see, fits here perfectly. Okay? This tap is a bit expensive. These are like $8 a piece. You can get the set for under $30, the set of three. This one tap in particular is $30. So yeah, you don't want to screw this up. Now, at the same time in buying these, I also bought a 3/8 by 27 thread per inch tap. That tap is also $30, by the way. And I bought a 3/8 by 32 threads per inch, which oddly enough was pretty cheap. It was like under $8, I believe. But regardless, be very cognizant. Don't screw up and put the wrong screw in the hole. If you happen to put the wrong screw in the hole and it stops moving like this, stop. Hands off. Remember the prime rule. Never force anything. Look at your hardware again. The coarser thread goes down here on the bottom. We get it lined up. We get the screws started. Actually, it's best doing this with the nut off. Screw in. Get it lined up. Take it from there. Now, when you're doing these adjustments, as we mentioned, this is just like we mentioned last week in the rock shafts. You get it so that it's just snug, and then you back it off. You want to have full, free, nice motion. Run your nut down. Double check. It didn't get super tight. Put your screwdriver through your wrench, hold the screw in position, tighten the nut with the wrench, and double check, and everything should still be nice and smooth and easy to go. So anyway, that's all I've got for you this week. I know this is a short one, but I thought this was more than important enough to spend a little bit of time with it. It can get very expensive if you strip out threads, assuming you can repair them. If you force something and you go really far, you might not be able to repair the threads. So be very, very cognizant of what hardware came out of where and make sure the right fastener goes back into the right hole. Well, that's what I've got for you for this week for Sunday Morning Quickies. This is probably the quickest of the Sunday Morning Quickies, being only one subject. Anyway, I'd like to wish everybody a very safe, healthy, and happy New Year. Thank you so much for watching, and we will see you on the next one.